Cash should be handed out to struggling Pollokshields businesses to help them get back on their feet after a devastating blaze, it has been claimed. Fire tore through a tenement block on Albert Drive last month, leaving traders to pick up the pieces. Five business owners are still waiting to be allowed into their premises, with two jewelers set to be demolished. A £5 million fund was set up following fires at the Glasgow School of Art Mackintosh building and Victoria's Nightclub to support Sauchiehall Street businesses, and councillors are calling on the Scottish Government to boost the recovery in Pollokshields. Police and fire officers are still investigating the cause of the blaze but say it could be difficult to uncover due to the extensive damage. Councillor Jon Molyneux, who represents the area, said community crowdfunding to support those affected had hit more than £3,500 but there would be an ongoing financial impact. Work must be carried out to ensure the area remains vibrant, he said at a meeting of the City Council's Pollokshields Area Partnership. It is having an impact on local businesses, it is noticeably quieter. Mr. Molyneux added there was a case to be made to the Scottish Government. His comments were echoed by fellow local representatives Norman MacLeod and Hanif Raja. Gordon Smith, from City Property, one of the council's arm's-length organisations, said five traders had still not been allowed access to the properties, including two jewellers. As soon as it is safe to do so, we will let them do so, he said. He added the two jewellers' premises would be lost as they are under parts of the tenement which need to be demolished. One has already suffered a partial collapse. Mr. Smith said, the chances of getting things out prior to demolition are very low. But, in response to a question from Mr. MacLeod, said, I'll be surprised if we can't retrieve the safe. It is understood the properties have building insurance, with Pollokshields Community Councillor Bill Fraser revealing there is a single policy for almost the whole block, which makes things a lot easier. Mr. MacLeod said he would pursue the possibility of help for all traders in the area in the same way some assistance was provided to traders in Sauchiehall Street. He also praised the emergency services for their response to the incident, which saw one man taken to hospital due to smoke inhalation. These officers risked their lives and they deserve every element of thanks for what they did, Mr. MacLeod said. A Police Scotland representative told the committee how an investigation was ongoing but because of the damage caused to the building it's going to be very difficult to get an exact cause of the fire. Firefighters have carried out safety visits and issued advice to people in area. Finance Safer. More on this story, visit the news article link.